This followed a report of Parliament's ICT committee read by the Vice Chairperson Tony Ayo, who asked Parliament to reject the passing into law of the National Information and Technology Authority Amendment Bill 2024 on grounds that NITA Uganda has not only generated money for Uganda but also saved government money.
Right Honourable Speaker, I beg to move that the bill titled the National Information Technology Authority Uganda Amendment Bill 2024 be read for the second time. Right Honourable Speaker, I beg to move.
Is the bill seconded? Is the bill seconded? Honourable members, the bill is seconded by Charity, by Rose, by local government, Esther, public service, water, Attorney General, Karamoja, by Honorable Gume, by Honorable Cuthbert Tom.
The committee concluded that retention of NITA Uganda outweighs the desire to merge or mainstream it back into the ministry. The committee further recommended that NITA Uganda be reinstated as a strategic semi-autonomous agency of government to spearhead the digital transformation program for socio-economic development of Uganda, and the bill for dissolution of NITA Uganda be rejected. MPs questioned why the government would ask Parliament to back the merger of NITA Uganda, yet all the same three grounds laid by the government to justify merger of institutions hadn't been met by the Minister of ICT. Legislators also punched holes in the
where government intend to achieve institutional harmony, reduce service duplications and overlaps, reduce administrative costs and service delivery. The spirit behind this is the emerging socio-economic and technological development which has called for introduction of a flat structure that enables MDAs to share common resources as well as have collaborative interaction across.
Legislators also punched holes in justification of duplication that was slapped against NITA Uganda by government.
The committee is saying that there is a failure to demonstrate the financial drain caused by NITA U on a consolidated fund, which has just been explained. Two, failure to demonstrate the duplication of roles between ministry, UCC, UTCL with NITA U. Three, the lack of oversight over the performance of the functions currently performed by NITA U.
We need more time, really. We need more time to gather all that evidence that is required so that the committee can have...
There is a procedure matter.
When the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, put the question on whether National Information Technology Authority Amendment Bill 2024 should be read for the second time, the nays had it.
That those in favour of us going for the second reading of the bill, those in favor say on the contrary, nay.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.